last left, the Vault Dweller. They were inside of the cathedral, searching for a passage down deep into its dingy bowels. And it was there that they found all manner of horrible creatures. Yes, not only super mutants, but the horrific floaters and centaurs as well. In addition to a slew of children of the cathedral donning their strange purple warlock robes. But also they found some poor test subjects who were being subjected to rather strange and cruel experiments. Lots of goop was all over the place, and people were talking about psionic powers. Now it was up to the Vault Dweller alone, with the followers of the apocalypse vanquished. It was up to the Vault Dweller alone to travel down deeper still and seek out the Master. This is Fallout!
Welcome back. Let's fucking do it, baby! Should we investigate these other folks, though? Yeah, we probably should. Alright, and this is very likely going to be the final everything. This will be the end of Fallout 1, I'm pretty sure, unless things go really fucking wild, which I guess is possible. Alright, let's see here. Oh, can we talk to them before we open that? No. Okay. What was repair again? I'm never gonna remember. It's gonna be especially even worse if in Fallout 2, the skill decks, like, hotkeys are different. Okay. Oh, shit. I can't open these. Do I actually have to use the terminal pad here? Let's see. Hey! We're free! We're free! Oh, God, no! Wow! Oh, my God! I'm assuming that this is because they were wearing explosive collars or something like that. And that it isn't because I turned on the pest control upstairs, right? This isn't on me, right? Remember earlier? Like, well, that was at the Mariposa. Okay. I'm not to blame here. All right. Whew, I almost thought that maybe this could have potentially been my fault. All right. Holy shit. What do they got? They got anything? Nah. Let's see here. Nah. Alright. Is there anything in these holding cells? No. What did this say again? You gain 2k XP for releasing prisoners from misery, only to see them violently explode. Right, more of this strange, noxious, biological goo. Here, let me pop a quick save there. Are. Great. Okay. Down and around this way. Alright. Very good. So we've looked through everything here, I believe. I think we're good to fucking go. Wow, I should not have freed him, huh? Okay, it's fine. And we checked up here. Right. Oh, no, we didn't look through this section. Yeah, there's some goodies up there. Okay. Look, we almost missed out on some potentially very useful goodies for what is to come. Watch there be, like, some sort of explosive collar shutdown code. Okay. Let's see. Oh, how do I pick again? Yeah, it's two. That's what I did. Oh, there we go. I must have just futzed up the targeting. Are. What's inside? More grenades. Plasma grenades and... Oh wait, these were the plasma ones. My bad. I keep doing that. What did we end up taking? Pulse grenades. Here, let's get rid of, like, three of them. And then that way we'll have a 50-50 split. Cool. For our plasma versus pulse. Alright, there we go. What have we got? We got some combat armor, some Nuka-Cola. Alright. Over here. And what's inside of this? Oh. 2,082 caps. Huh. I mean, I guess, you know what? It is useful because there's a chance that you come here first, right? Okay. Let's see over here. Another monitor. Alright. Yeah, now we're good to go, I think. Alright. I was hoping for some healing stuff, but sure, we got a few grenades out of it. Not that I'm even sure we'll need to use it, but it's good to have a backup plan. Because I think we should just be able to start blasting. We're already on the second floor. Okay, and third. Oh shit, let's do a quick save. So what are we working with here? Is this not... Oh, there's even more to it. Alright, fair enough. Are these robos hostile? It seems as if they are. Oh shit, there's a patrol coming. Okay, there's the room where they keep all the water. I do like that this floor is, like, extremely similar to our vaults. Right? But not identical, I don't think, right? Because over here is where the overseer would be. Okay. Are you all hostile? Exterminate! Okay, Jesus Christ. Let's start blasting. Let's go for the sensors. There we are. Critically hit for 64. This is just called robot? Yeah, this is just called robot. It has 113 HPs. Okay, I'm gonna flee.
Intruder must be destroyed!
Alright. Oh, dear lord. They're getting the full surround. Look at these little robo dudes blasting my whole ass up. Jeez! Oh my god, am I gonna die? Holy shit, they're a greater danger to me than the huge ones, I think. Fuck, I can't even see what the hell's going on in here.
Sensor hit, sensor hit!
Let's go for that one again, I think. It still lives. Can I eat all these hits? I mean, we did quick save. Jeez, dude. Oh my god. This is like when you get to the end game of a match of civilization, you know? Turns end up taking like a million fucking years. Oh shit, I didn't do an aim shot. Okay, let's try that again. Good shit. Let's go for this one. There we are. Good. Okay, should probably heal after this volley of attacks.
Combat sequence initiated.
Jeez, dude. Okay. Let's get our healing going on. Good. Alright. Our max health is 92. Always forget that you can see it right here at the top of your sheet. There we are. Good. And let's blast one of these little assholes. Perfect. And I'm going to move for two.
Enemy termination sequence begun!
Okay. Perfect. Let's get this other little one in the sensors. It's a miss. In the sensors again. They'll have to do. Let's move for two. The termination sequence has begun. Again. Okay. Good. I'm surprised that none of these versions of robots made it into the newer games, you know? Like, I'm assuming this is what would become of the iBots, you know? The iBots look kind of like that, and this would be like a Handy, a Mr. Handy. This would be a handy. Okay. Oh, shit. Oh my god! I was crit for 35. Okay, let's play it safe. We have the stim packs to do it. There we go. Get topped off again. Great. Okay. Is one of these lower than the other in some way? Have I hit one before? Yeah, I did. Okay. Let's go for the sensor. It's not a kill shot. Okay. Can I move it all out of here? Or am I just... They're fully surrounding me in a major way. Okay. Well, I guess I'll just reload. There we are.
Intruder must be destroyed!
Okay. And let's blast you. Sensors again. Yeah, I'm still not sure anymore about the sensors versus CPU situation. I keep going back and forth. That said, we did just one-shot that one. I feel like, you know what? I'm sold back again. Okay. Let's see. Oh, shit. I do want to take any sort of energy ammo off of them if they have it. It doesn't seem like it. How about these big butts over here? Nope, nothing. Alright. Can I interact with computer? It's all gooped up. Minigun. 5mm JHP. Here, let's swap our weapon. Okay. Good. Well, nothing there. The amount of goo on this computer makes it very difficult to access. Alright. Let's do a quick save. And down over this way. Okay. You see a super mutant with a cigarette dangling from his mouth. 50 HP.
An intruder!
Alright. Sure. Jeez.
No one can save you!
No one can save you! Go for the eyes! Gotcha. Oh, this person had a name. Vicious. Huh, were they like a mini-boss or something? They had very little health. Alright, let's end combat. Ooh, there are hostiles near. Okay, I'll take a super stim pack. Or can I? There's a flamer. Can I take another... no? So what's coming after me? Are all these assholes now on the move? Oh shit, yeah, these assholes are definitely on the move. Okay. Oh shit. Everybody's coming to the kill zone. Okay. Fine. Let them come. Oh fuck. Alright, yeah.
Who is stupid enough to anger us?
Holy shit, there are so many. Alright. Let us heal up ahead of time. That way we can devote all of our AP to just blasting. There we go. And then, should I move directly into the doorway? I feel like I should. There we go. Rotate for maximum action. Can I blast from here? No, I cannot, which means they probably can't blast me. And turn. You poor fools. You're walking right into my secret choke point trap. All right, now? There's no time for blasting, but I can move ahead one hex, and then the blasting begins. I missed. And then the blasting begins. Hell yes. I move back into shelter.
Oh no! Now you die a burning death!
Uh-oh. Okay. How bad of a burning death am I gonna get here? Let's go for the eyes. Boom! Oh, hell yeah. Oh, look, we can go for the eyes here again. Oh, around the corner. Trick shot, baby. All right. Let's reload.
I see enemies to destroy.
All right. The warlocks have come. Let's see. How powerful are they? Oh, you see a technician. He is working diligently for the Unity and the Master. Okay, 40 HP. So we should still do aim shots right under the eyes. Oh, shit.
I'm gonna put you on the spot for that.
Go for the eyes again. There we go. Good stuff. End turn. Here they come. Oh, shit. You're blasting me. Holy shit, that hurt. Okay. What did you shoot me with? A plasma pistol? Boom. Got you in one. Okay. How about this a-hole? There we go. Go for the eyes. Oh, beautiful. Two for two. Okay. Let us end turn. We'll take the extra armor or AC. There we are. Doesn't sound great. Okay. Oh, they friendly fired. Ah, very good. All right. Go for this asshole in the distance. And this one right up in our grill. Beautiful. Look at this. This is going great. All right. End turn again. Okay, we can eat those hits. It's fine. What is this asshole wielding? A flamethrower. And that one has a Gatling laser. Okay, let's take care of the Laser Lord. Oh, I missed. Laser Lord, be gone. Hell yes. All right, and turn. Beautiful. Did we just fucking get them all? I feel like we did. Hell yes. Wow, I got a level out of it and everything. Fucking A. Alright. I didn't even know there were higher levels in this. Shit. Alright, what do I want? Fuck, I don't know. What's there to even want at this point? Yeah, I don't know. Maybe we just leave it as is? Oh, we can put shit into throwing again. Right? If I do want to use these grenades. I don't know. If it gets sticky, like a whole group of them like that, except they all come at once, could be a good time for a grenade. Okay. Good. And let's heal on up here. Let's see. There we are. Good. Get that health up. Beautiful. 97 is our new health cap. Okay. What have we got here on the ground? A super stim pack. I still cannot lift it. It's too powerful. Okay. A plasma rifle. That has MF cells, though. Microfusion. How about that? That's a super stim pack. Shit. Okay, nothing in that little charred remain. Okay, over here. What does the Gatling laser use? Oh, it also uses MF cells. Okay. There are standard stim packs here, though. That's definitely worth taking. Okay. Let's see, another stim pack. Another Gatling laser. Yeah, I think we'll definitely go with heavy weapons in Fallout 2. I think that could be fun. Maybe we should also not crank our health up so, or our int up so high. Because we kind of, like, at this point, we have, like, an overabundance of skill points. That said, maybe there's more skills or more useful skills in Fallout 2.
To the death!
I should have just shot you. Okay. Go for the eyes.
Oh, Pain, what have you done?
There we go. Good. Wow, that was a pretty low crit. We'll just hold here. Alright. Another asshole coming in for the kill. Good. Let's finish this dude off, hopefully. Good shit. Maybe we'll get lucky and one-shot this flamer fool. Hell yes. Alright, wow, a 201 crit. Amazing. Okay. Let's reload. What have you got? Yeah, flamer. Bottle caps. Why not? Okay. What did this dickhead have? Oh, a laser rifle. That's useful. Oh, no, wait. That's also MF cells. Boo. Okay. So that's probably where we gotta go. Okay. Let's see. We'll pick into this shit. Anything good in here? I'm so surprised that there are, like, not any booby traps everywhere in here, you know? I would have assumed that this entire place would be flush with them. Thank goodness, though. Not a fan of booby traps and shit. It's scary. All right, yeah, it has flamer fuel, rocket launcher. Okay. Let's pop open this locker. What have we got? Minigun and a Gatling laser. Did I ever read the info on a Gatling laser? I don't think so. An H&K L30 Gatling laser, designed specifically for military use. These were in the prototype stage at the beginning of the war. Multiple barrels allow stronger, longer firing before overheating. Powered by microfusion cells. Minimum strength of 6. What's the minimum strength on the standard minigun? 7. Makes sense. Okay. A Rockwell CZ-53 personal minigun. I think I mentioned this before, but I'm pretty sure Rockwell CZ-53, or at least the CZ, was used again in New Vegas for like a unique minigun or heavy weapon. Okay. Alright, over here. Let's do a quick save. Good, good, good. Oh, we should check out this massive inventory room. We didn't have the opportunity. Okay, what's inside? Explosive ammo. Alright, how about this one? Right, some grenades. We're already good on grenades, I think. If anything, I'd rather carry around some of those super stim packs, right? Oh my gosh. Alright, here we go. Here's some energy cell. Oh, fuck. Alright. Let's see. Take one of them? No. Can't be done. Eey. What should I get rid of? I guess I could get rid of the robes. Not really using them anymore. I think we're beyond the pale for deciding to don them to use them. Oh, it's locked, of course. Over here. Oh my gosh, a treasure trove of drugs. Let's take all that. It is interesting that we're being given rad away when we don't really need it. Right? Will there be an area in here that's highly irradiated? I guess it's possible. Oh look, I was able to take super stim packs. Oh, shit. Okay, good. And a bunch of money. Like, once you join the Brotherhood, do you end up going anywhere? Is it possible to go anywhere that's, like, irradiated? I don't know. Because the main threat would be the glow, right? Okay. Let's take care of these warlocks and shit. Oh, whoops. Stowed my weapon. I want to sneak. Oh, definitely not sneaking there. Alright, let's blast this fool. Gotcha. Super mutant soldier is down. Can I end turn? There we go. Yeah, we'll wait for them to file in toward us. There we go. There we are. Hell yes. That's everybody. Alright. Stow that away. Let's see, we got any goodies down here on the ground? Super stim pack, can I hold it? I can! Okay. Another one. What is this, a laser rifle? If only I could unload it. Oh, what is this, small energy cell? How many rounds do I have? I'm back up to 600. We're probably good, I would say. Okay. Anything else? Oh, what's this? Actually, oh, is this actually the final? Oh, there could. Oh, okay. All right, yeah, I think that door right there might actually be what we're looking for. So where does this go? Hang on, let's do a quick save. So this should go to that motherfucker. Yeah, that's gonna lead us to the big boss. Okay. Wait, so where the fuck does this shit go? Hang on. I quicksaved, right? Yeah. Okay. Let's see. Down here. It's locked, of course. Oh, couldn't pick it. Give it another shot. Nope, give it another shot. Nope, give it another shot. Nope, give it another shot. Okay, wow. What the fuck? How about we use some of that? Oh shit, I don't have my tools on me anymore. Okay. I got my... Oh no, wait, I do. There we go. Good. And then try it again. Couldn't pick it. Jeez. What the fuck? How about my electronic pick? Huh? Wow. Holy shit, I did it. At first, I didn't think it would even be possible. Okay. This one, is it even locked? Yeah, it is locked. Okay. There we go. Wow, where the fuck does this shit go? Fourth floor. I thought this would take us to the big boss, but what the fuck is this? Ew. Let's look at the nasty wall. Okay, it's the same description as before. Is this one locked up too? Fuck, it is. Okay. Huh, there we are. Let's pull out our weapon. What's up, asshole?
Suffer, human!
Thanks. Okay. Do they have names? No, I don't think so. Super Mutant Sergeant? Okay. Let's go for the eyes on this asshole, where they take their turn, and then get you in the eyes. Oh! Oh, okay. I thought they just absorbed all the damage. It's like, oh shit, they mean fucking business! Okay. There we go, and turn. Oh, I get another turn. Okay. Love that. There we go. Oh, eat a fucking butt. Okay. There we are. Let's reload. And let's swap our weapon again. Quick save. What is this? Super stim pack? Yeah. Take those. Oh, can't carry it. A power fist. Huh. Let's inspect it. A big frigger power fist from Beat Co. Considered by many to be the ultimate weapon to use in unarmed combat. Others are just scared. Powered by small energy cells. Minimum of one strength. Huh. Okay. Let's see. Anything else here? What is this? Is this just like some weird shit on the ground? I think so. Okay, computer console. What is this? This is a nuclear warhead. Is it? This is a nuclear bomb. It looks very dangerous just sitting there. What? Okay. Huh. Oh, okay. This is another way to end things here. This is like more attuned for sneaky characters who just want to get in and out, I think. Right? Hence why all of the doors were locked, right? So if you were a character that invested in sneaky shit, you could just sneak past enemies using like stealth boys and whatnot. Or just your own sneaking capabilities, perhaps. Okay. What does this even say, though? Let's see. This computer is labeled Atomic Access Computer. There are cables running from the access computer to the warhead behind it. Okay. Should I science it? Oh. You fail to learn anything. You are not skilled enough to defeat the security mechanism. What if I keep trying? Okay. You have armed the warhead. A timer with 4 minutes has started a countdown. Ah! Revert! I don't want that. I don't know how long it'll take me to kill that asshole. Okay. I thought I would bring up a UI, not just immediately like, oh, surely if you're interacting with a nuclear warhead, there's only one thing you want to do. Okay, sure. Let us use some of this. Good. Oh, you know what? We'll use one more too. Well, at least we have that just in case I, for some reason, cannot defeat this horrible asshole. Right? All right. Let's get over here. Ready for action. Good, good, good. And we'll pop a quick save. Look at this, the big scary run down the hall. All right. Ooh, you have to... Look, they very intentionally set it to where you have to pan up to see. Ah, no, what the fuck? Okay, floating eye. See nothing out of the ordinary. You see the master of the super mutants. He has 500 HPs and is wielding a Gatling laser with 30 shots of MFC. Okay, and some computers. Right. And of course, the master is melded with the overseer's super chair 500. Good thing that motherfucker could not see me running down this very obvious choke point. Right? What a great way to just unload on people right here. Good thing you can't see shit.
So what shall it be? Do you join the Unity, or do you die here?
Join.
Die.
Join.
Die.
All right. And I don't know about anybody else, but as even if you're vaguely interested in Fallout, I feel like you, if you've played one game to completion, you have seen this interaction, you know? I feel like, I don't know, maybe that's a too wild of an assumption, but I know, like, the first time I finished Fallout 1, I looked up this motherfucker and, like, the conversation and everything, but it is pretty cool, right? It is pretty cool, but as you can see, they've, like, melded together with the machines, you know? Which is kind of interesting, I guess, in retrospect, thinking about sort of some of the themes that Fallout 4 was, like, trying to get at. But I don't know. I guess they just didn't quite hammer it home if that is what they were going for. I'm not sure. But, you know, sort of like a synthesis of flesh and machinery, in a way. I don't know. Anyway. I can't win. I'll join you. Just immediately. If you can prove to me that your unity is the best course for humanity, then I will help you. How about you die, then I leave? Oh, there will be death today, but not mine. I've got a plan. All right, and of course, this would be the speech option. I'm pretty sure. Right? We'll go down it and fail it, I think. Right? If you can prove to me that your unity is the best course for humanity, then I will help you. Watch us end up just helping, right? Because our speech is too low. We're like, oh, fuck. Wow, you convinced me. Wow, you know what? I thought you were a horrible asshole, but sign me up.
I don't have to prove anything to you.
Prove.
Your ego demands you tell me. All villains have this strange urge to explain everything. I can't know you represent the best future unless you prove it to me. Let's go with that.
Very demanding for one in your
tenuous
position. But I can
respect
your needs.
So tell me.
The Unity will bring about the master race.
Master!
One able to survive, or even
thrive,
in the wasteland. As long as there are differences, we will
tear ourselves apart,
fighting each other. We need one race.
Race!
One goal.
Goal!
Goal!
One people to move forward to our destiny. Destiny.
I do kind of like as well. This was sort of... I don't know. I can't help but compare it to some of the other Fallout villains of yore who sort of have similar takes as to what, like, you know, in this case, it's definitely like, you know, it's very clear they're going for like, oh yeah, the master race and all that shit with the super mutants. But also thinking to like Caesar and Caesar's Legion, right? It was sort of, they had the one sort of ideology that could guarantee humanity's survival, right? That was sort of Caesar's argument, is that it's a cruel way of life in some respects, you may think, but it is a way of survival or whatever, right? And I try to think about, like, well, I guess I don't know too much about the Enclave other than they want things to return to how they were, in a sense, right? With them in a seat of power. I know the Enclave are, like, the major big bad of Fallout 2, but that's about it. Like, I know very rough things about Fallout 2. I know that there's, like, an oil rig. I know that there's, like, a really funny dude at a vertibird. That's... I don't know the fine print. Okay. Anyway. Let's see. That race being the mutants, of course.
Of course. The mutants will survive. The mutants will rebuild this world. And only as a mutant will you be allowed to live.
Live.
Die.
All you care about is your mutants and their unity. Live, die. Live.
Excellent. Your talents will be
useful.
But first, you must tell me everything about your vault.
Why?
I will conquer it and turn all those pure strain
humans
into mutants. They will give me the army I need to bring
peace to the entire wasteland.
Sorry, I don't like that plan much. Sounds reasonable. Let's do it. I'm not, like, accidentally fulfilling the requirements somehow, am I? No. No, because I think we fucked it up just before. All right. Sorry, I don't like that plan much.
So be it. You've dug your own grave.
Grave, grave!
Okay, here we go. It's rumble time, I think.
You think you can destroy me?
Destroy
me?
Oh, God. Hey, only hit me for 5. We can do this. All right. Good. I do highly recommend, if this is your first time seeing Fallout 1, there's so many people who have, like I said, like I did it, but there's so many people who have uploaded the talk your way out of this solution for this, the speech option. I would totally recommend looking it up. It is pretty interesting and cool that it exists. But also, on the other hand, like, you know, sometimes you come to face-to-face. I feel like maybe the master, because of how it goes down... I don't know. No. Yeah, I would still fucking kill the master. Right? You're just too far gone. You're too far gone to... Right? But I couldn't help... But, like, one of the more compelling things is that you sort of, like, spoilers, I guess, in a sense, even though we're already here at the end. You compel the master to blow themselves up, right? They like, initiate self-destruction on the nuclear warhead. I can't remember exactly how it went down for what's-his-ass at the end of New Vegas. Oh, my gosh, with the big helmet? My God, I can't remember what their name was. They had such a striking name, too, and they were very important in the storyline and all that. But, you know, Caesar's right-hand man. But, if I remember correctly, the speech options there, it was such a cool way that you could do it, but I didn't really enjoy it. I don't know, in some sense it felt kind of contrived, and, like, I don't know, they were such a big piece of shit. Like, I did want to meet them with force. I did want to fucking take them out for all the fucked up shit that they have done, you know? Like, I'm all for, you know, redemption, rehabilitating people who have done wrongs, But at some point, when you're engaged in, like, trying to create a master race, trying to enslave a shitload of people, like, forcing people into labor and all that shit, like, I gotta, if I'm afforded the opportunity, I gotta take the shot. You're, like, horrible. All right. Let's see. Over here. Let's take care of the trash. Boom. Uh-oh. Okay. Good. And then, I could probably just stand here, right? Let's see. I'm getting shot at. 6 HP. Oh, shit. Wow, the little motherfucker hit me for 22! Oh my god. Okay. Go for the CPU. Can I shoot the master from here? No. Okay. I can't open inventory either, can I? No. Alright, we'll just move back into the position. Okay. Oh, fuck! Wow! I got crit for 221. Holy shit! Oh my god! Okay, maybe we should not prioritize the little babies if you're capable of that.
Your life ends in the wasteland.
Okay. Alright, here we go. Done. Let's head on back. I do want to do it fair and square. I want to, like, have a super-ass showdown here. Okay.
So what shall it be? Do you join the Unity, or do you die here?
Let's exhaust another...
Die!
Join!
Die!
Oh, there will be death today, but not mine. I got a plan.
Oh, please. What sort of
plan
might that be?
I'll kill you, and that'll make it difficult for you to continue, right? I convinced the Brotherhood of Steel to invade this place if I was captured and not set free. They will be here any moment. I kind of want to hear what the Master will say to this. I'll kill you and that'll make it difficult for you to continue, right?
You think
oh,
you can
okay. There we go. So long as we don't get hit with that crit right away. Probably okay. Let's see. The head, the eyes. I like how it is this eye here. The frame, the CPU. I wonder which one is better. The CPU or the eyes. Let's go for the eyes. Okay, wow. The Master was critically hit in the eyes for 114 points, breaking past the bio-organic defenses. Okay, let's go for the CPU now. Ah! Master was critically hit in the CPU for 27 hit points. The attack against the Master seems to do less damage than it should have. Oh. Okay. Let's end turn. Hopefully we don't get fucked up here.
You shall pay for what you have done.
Done.
Okay. Inspect. You still got more to go. Okay. Go for the eyes again.
Ah.
I think the little eyeball is the way to go.
Ah.
Okay. And turn again.
Oh, fuck! 203. Fucking A.
All right.
Jeez.
The worst part is, like, you're already dead.
Not even.
And you're overkilled so bad, like, the little ticker at the bottom just has to keep going until it runs out. All right. Okay. I think we can do it. Right? I think we can do it. Do I have any way to, like, buff up my shit in some sense? I guess I could pop some buff out, right? That'll power up my max health, won't it? Hell yeah. Let's do some drugs. Uh-oh, I'm addicted. Okay. It's fine. All right. There we are. Good.
So what shall it be? Do you join the Unity?
How about you die, then I leave?
You think?
Yeah, okay. Let's fuck. Be funny, we just get one shot right from the get-go. Okay, go for the eye. There we are, 142. 112 in turn. Okay. Got hit for 12. Okay. I got scared. I thought that one was a powered up one. Okay, again. Good. That one was not that good. 43 only. Alright. 33 only. Ooh, we might be fucked. Come on. Ooh! Oh, shit. Okay. Go for the eye again. Please. Go for the eye.
Yes! Yes, you fucker! Eat a bot!
Oh, yeah. Start dripping. Start fucking dripping. Okay. Let's move one back this way. Cool. Oh, we should read this. Master was critically hit in the eyes for 175 hit points, breaking past, yada yada. Master was killed. The pedestal looks as if it were slowly breathing in and out. Oh shit, I'm timed right now. Okay. Wait, am I still getting shot at? Who's shooting me? That's not good. Does the whole place, like, go on detonation mode after you kill the fucker? It sure does seem that way. The master soldier is out of ammo for the Gatling laser. Oh, it's some asshole from behind. Okay, that's fine. Boom. Okay. Get you. Good shit. Oh shit. Getting my ass knocked around. Okay. Go for the CPU. Good. Oh shit. Single shot. Good. Okay. And then go for the eyes. Good stuff. And combat. Okay. Let's do a hard save here and be like, shit is blowing up. Lol. Okay. Let's see. Inspect. Anything here? Let's stow away our weapon. Can I look through this shit? Can I look through any of this shit? Nope, I can't get there. I can't get there. What about this one? It's covered in shit. Okay, I'm getting the fuck out. Bring up inventory. Heal. Fast mode heals. Good. Back up to max. Holy shit. I'm just like fucked up on roids right now. I'm like massively addicted, just ran out of this place. Covered, dripping, pouring, and sweat, and the weird master goop. There's like weird nasty viscera all over my bod. I'm just running out here like some sort of like deranged fucking lunatic. Okay. Explains the ending. It's really gonna explain the ending a lot better. Alright, there we go. 178 seconds remaining. Shut the fucking door! Okay, it's fine. Alright. Oh my god. Is blunt smoking. Let's get out of here. Alright. Hang on, should I reload real quick? I don't know if there's gonna be fuckers out here or not. We got what, 2 minutes? No, we got over 2 minutes. We got almost 3 minutes. We can do that. Right? We can make that. Oh shit. Is time passing as I interact with stairs? Okay. Fucking run, man, run! Fucking run, everybody! Get the fuck out of here! There's a fucking bomb! Alright. There we go. Am I good here? This shit's gonna blow up! Let's see. Fuck off, my feet! My feet! Alright, I'm getting the hell out. What is- shit! 2 minutes now. All right. Hey! in retrospect, with their motif, it's kind of obvious there was a nuclear bomb in there.
The death of the master was the first major step towards ending his mad dream of conquest and enforced peace. But it is the destruction of the vats that neutralizes the mutant threat. Without the ability to create more mutants and enforce their harsh brand of justice, the mutant armies flee to the east, beyond the no man's land. The mutant attack on Necropolis spares none of its ghoulish inhabitants. After the mutant armies advance, they leave a truly dead city behind them.
Oh, this is the non-canon stuff because we took too long.
The mutant armies, led into battle by the fierce super mutants, destroy the followers of the apocalypse.
Oh, fuck.
Barely human carrion feeders pick over the followers' remains. In Shady Sands, Tandy helps her father Aradesh bring a new community and new life out of the broken remains of the world. They are responsible for the new California Republic, whose ideals spread across the land.
Mm.
Killian Darkwater takes firm control of Junktown.
Wait, Shady Sands was all right?
Kind, and then enforces his own brand of frontier justice. Life is fair and safe under his law. The Brotherhood of Steel helps the other human outposts drive the mutant armies away with minimal loss of life on both sides of the conflict.
What was up with this?
The advanced technology of the Brotherhood is slowly reintroduced into New California with little disruption or chaos. The Brotherhood wisely remains out of the power structure and becomes a major research and development house.
That is not canon, right? That doesn't happen.
Before the might of the mutant army.
Fuck.
You will never recover.
Jeez.
The Desert Raiders pillage most of the northern parts of New California. They are a scourge that lasts for years, until a rebel army of mutants brings them down. Your involvement with the various places and people of the wasteland is well documented by future historians. Only a single question remained unanswered. What happened to you?
You've done it. That's wonderful, amazing. I'm so proud of what you've accomplished, what you've endured.
More.
There's no way that people of the Vault can ever thank you enough for what you've done. You've saved all our lives. Who knows? Maybe even save the human race. Yes. That makes the rest of this even harder. Everyone will want to talk to you. Every youngster will look up to you and want to emulate you. And then what? They'll want to leave. What happens to the Vault if we lose the best of a generation? What if we are the only safe place in the world? You just gave us back all these lives. I can't take the chance of losing them. I've made a lot of tough decisions since I took this position, but none of them harder than this one. You saved us, but you'll kill us. I'm sorry. You're a hero. And you have to leave.
This always struck me as so fucking weird as an ending. Like, I kind of enjoy the bittersweetness of it, but I'm pretty sure we get zero agency in this. Yeah, I don't even have a mouse right now. Oh, that's it then.
When you are all alone.
Right, it is a little wild how, like, no matter what, because all throughout the rest of the game, it's like, oh yeah, you have agency in this. You could do, like, you could pass speech checks. You could opt to shoot this fucking dude. You could go along with it, right? But right there, no matter what, You're always casted out like that. Huh. Which I guess it is a necessary evil in some ways, because isn't that tied directly into Fallout 2? I don't know for sure, though. Like I said, I know very little about it. Anyway, hey, this is Fallout 1. Pretty short, right? But pretty sweet, I would say. I would say it has aged extremely well. It's still incredibly playable by modern standards, I would say. Even more so than, like I said before, last game we played, Baldur's Gate. Because the, like, VATS combat is so simple for people to understand, especially, like, it's not terribly far removed from current day XCOM or similar strategy games like that. Or shit, even Wasteland, right? The new Wasteland 3 game, you know? It's still incredibly playable, and, like, in my case, I've played, like, a pretty standard version of it, just with one mod to add back in kids, right? You could play it even without that. Because they put out those compatibility patches or whatever at some point, right? I think there was a certain point of irony or whatever, where Fallout 3, because it was on Games for Windows Live for a long-ass time, I think they fixed this, though, like, last year or 2 years ago. But it was unplayable. You had to go through some weird shit in order to get even playable. Because I remembered I played Fallout 3 in preparation because I was so excited for Fallout 4 coming out. And I had to go jump through some weird hoops just to get it running. Wow. But yeah, really well paced. I would say maybe the only part that felt kind of slow is maybe just due in part to the fact that I already knew a lot about the lore. I'm talking about when we went to the glow and all of that. Right? Because at the base there, it was just like a lot of lore dumps in the various logs and texts, you know? And a lot of that I mostly already knew. It was just like details and specifics that were kind of like new or whatever. And that felt a little slow, but I have to wonder if maybe that's more compelling to someone playing through it for the first time and is unaware of that stuff, right? But yeah, it's a lot easier than I thought it would be, right? I remember people saying like, oh yeah, they're pretty tough. I don't know. I thought it wasn't too bad, right? What else? Like, I don't know. It's just aged pretty well. I'm very eager to see Fallout 2 because people have said that has aged even better, right? It's just like a better version of this, and already this was like shockingly good, you know? I think the VATS combat system really helped keep it up to date and like very simple to comprehend, right? Like we said before, the skill deck system is very simple to understand, right? Which in a sense you do need to think about that when you're designing those systems from the bottom up, because just to compare it to Baldur's Gate, which came out like a year later after this one, roughly, I believe, Baldur's Gate uses systems already implemented by tabletop role-playing games and like specific names and locations and even and all that, right? So if you played Baldur's Gate, you could be like, oh yeah, I'm already familiar with this rule set because of course I regularly play these other games which share systems and rules with this computer game now, right? Whereas in the case of Fallout, you're having to introduce all these systems for the first time to players, right? So it's in your interest to keep it kind of like easier to wrap your head around, you know? I don't know. It was just really fucking good. Fallout 1. I don't really have too much else to say about it. Like, there was a shockingly robust fucking voice cast, you know? The animations and stuff were, like, frankly ahead of their era, as was a lot of the voice acting.
Right, because like I said, in the 90s, like, you were very hit or miss, right? You either got shit like this, or you got, I thought you would almost be a Jill sandwich. You really ran the gamut there with all that shit. I don't know, Fallout 1. Fucking wild and amazing. I figure maybe I will upload a mirror version of this without the Ink Spots maybe playing. Maybe I'll put over the same song that we use for the opening, just in case there's people watching this and the video is not playable in their country due to copyright concerns or whatever. I know sometimes that comes up. So I'll just have like an unlisted mirror that you can click in the bottom. I'll pin a comment or whatever, similar to how I did for the very first video. You know, it feels very fitting to have that all here and all that. And look, featuring the voices of. Wow. Huh. Oh my god, Rhombus was Clancy Brown? Holy shit! Clancy Brown, famous for doing Lex Luthor a whole lot in cartoons. And also, I guess more recently, he was in... Fucking, what was that game? I haven't ever played any of their games, but he was in Detroit Become Human. And they even casted him to look like the character he played looked like him as well. But probably currently his most known role is that he's fucking Mr. Krabs from SpongeBob SquarePants. Clancy Brown fucking rocks. Wow. Like I said, yeah, what a fucking slew of voice actors. And of course here, Morpheus, we didn't even get to hear this asshole talk. Alright. Additional voice work by Max the Dog. Aww. They were real dog... no... sounds? Aw, how sweet. Wow. I kind of like the tradition of the Fallout games incorporating, like, a dog actor in some ways. That's kind of, I don't know, it's very endearing. Wow. Warning, it is a violation of federal copyright law to copy, duplicate, or reproduce this program or any portions of this program without the express written permission of the copyright owner. Right, yeah. This one's definitely getting demonetized. Or it's all going to whoever owns the rights to the Ink Spots or whatever. Right. Oh, right, which reminds me, yeah, of course, thanks to everybody watching through the playthrough. Very much appreciate it. Thanks to folks who have left comments, left likes, replied to other folks' comments, subbed, hit up the Patreon, hit up the PayPal or the Ko-fi, all that shit. Thank you very much. In whatever way, it's always appreciated. Even if you just watch this one. Oh, look. Special thanks to the X-Files, Xena, Buffy, The Simpsons, ER, the talking, the last minute dog talking, what? And that's it. There are no more credits. Stop looking. All right. Wow. And after... oh. There are more credits! Fallout was brought to you by Interplay Productions, Team Fallout, and the letter Q. Have a nice day. Okay. All right, Interplay. What do you think? They're going to say something else after this? I don't know. But after this, we will play... we will go back to Baldur's Gate. Baldur's Gate 1 specifically, but it's complicated. We'll be playing the new Baldur's Gate DLC that everybody says is pretty fucking rough. We'll be playing that one. It's new because it's made... it's such a weird situation with that because this new DLC is fucking... it's made like... in 2015 or something like... no, I can't remember exactly when. But it's made like within 10 years ago, I think. Shit, maybe now. Not anymore. I don't know. Maybe it was like in 2011 or something, right? I don't fucking know. Or beyond 2011, I guess. But, or yeah, 2011 could be over 10 years ago now. Yeah, depends on the month. But, yeah, we'll go back and we'll play that. I specifically wanted to have it kind of divided out on its own rather than us leading directly from Baldur's Gate into that new DLC. That way we could get kind of the same feel that people had whenever they came out with the Enhanced Edition. They were like, oh, maybe I'll try the Siege of Dragonspear, right? All these years later, right? After not remembering a bunch of shit or whatever and all that, right? They go back and you go play this and you're just like, oh, this is it, huh? Okay. So we'll get that same experience. And then we'll go into Baldur's Gate 2. And we'll probably play Baldur's Gate 2 and all of its DLC in just one run through. Because it's all very connected. Unlike this Baldur's Gate 1 Enhanced Edition special DLC or whatever. Right. And then after that special DLC, which I have no idea how long it is. Like I said, it might be lengthy. Because it came out so far after the fact and was made by a completely different development house. It was made by Beamdog, who did the porting, who did the, like, remaster. So it could be, like, a full-ass game. I don't fucking know. I have no idea. Or it could be, like, super-duper short. Either way, we'll play that, and then we'll play Fallout 2. And then after Fallout 2, we will play Baldur's Gate 2, right? And somewhere along the way... Oh, shit. Well, I better... And then somewhere along the way... Here, let's bring up game preferences. There we go. And somewhere along the way, we'll get into Fallout. We'll get into the newer era of Fallout. We'll play 3, replay New Vegas, play 4, right? But that'll be unaffected by the sort of CRPG schedule. We'll just squeeze that in somewhere along the way, right? I don't know how or exactly we'll manage that, but we'll squeeze it in there at some point, right? We'll get it in there. Also, at some point, I would enjoy playing the Fallout Tactics game, which I've heard is, like, pretty decent as well. And it should be a lot more like the modern Wasteland games and XCOM and whatnot, which also we should probably play Wasteland 2 and 3. I don't know if I can play Wasteland 1. I tried it in my free time, like, a couple years ago or something, around the time that Wasteland 3 came out. And holy shit, it's fucking rough. Like, maybe the only way I could get through it is if I said on the very, like, super fucking easy. Because on highest difficulty, you have just got to, like, grind shit out. Right? So I don't know about that. And it's not terribly compelling. I gotta say, it is just not terribly compelling. It's, like, it's worth looking at to sort of see the lineage of these games, right? But I don't know about playing it for the channel. I don't know. If we do play it, I'll play it on, like, super easy so we can, like, go through it super fast. I'm not sure. It'll definitely be one of those playthroughs that's mostly done in the name of academics rather than, like, oh, there will be some joy to be had here. Maybe there'll be some joy. But it'll mostly be born of irony. I don't know. Huh. Yeah, it's something to consider. But I would definitely like to play through Fallout 2. Or Wasteland 2 and 3. Definitely Fallout 2 as well, but, you know. Let's see. Is that it? Yeah, I think that's it. Yeah. Once again, thanks everyone for watching. Even if you only watched this one, thanks for leaving comments, likes, all that stuff. We won't begin the Baldur's Gate business for a little bit because, as I mentioned a while back, I'd be out of town, so there'll be a little bit of, like, I don't know, a lull. Similar to how there was as well, just between Baldur's Gate 1 and Fallout 1. There'll be a bit of a lull because I'll be out of town. I won't be able to even start working on shit. So it kind of worked out for me that we ended it, like, right before I'm going out of town for attending this second of two weddings. Just attending, let me be clear. And we'll be out for roughly a week or so. Because I figured, hey, in the area, so I'll be seeing my mom as well. Why not? And let's see. Is there anything else? Yeah, thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subbing, commenting. Thanks for hitting up Patreon, coffee, PayPal, shit like that. follow me on Twitter. Sometimes I post real life pictures on Instagram. What else is there? There's someday I would like to get back to streaming. There's an archive channel with a whole bunch of old streams. Yeah, I mentioned playing Fallout 76. There's a few archive streams of me playing 76. If you're interested in seeing some of that. Oh gosh, I don't even know how old that was. That might be before I got my current mic. I don't even know. I can't remember. Too dumb. But yeah, I think that's it. Yeah. Thanks for watching. It's been Fallout 1. Wow. See you next time for Fallout 2. People say it's a good one. Look out. Strap in for falling out of your seat with excitement. Wow. Bye, 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 bye. Take care. Oh, gosh, I just waved my hands like you can see me. Bye, bye, bye. Have a good one, please. Take care of each other.
Welcome to Shady Sand, stranger. Please holster that weapon while you are here.
Okay. Yes, sir. How do I do it?
Sorry. My brain is fucked up. I don't know how to put it away. I just start stabbing myself. I'm sheathing it.
Is this fucking NPC named Lyle? What the fuck?
Oh my god. This has never happened to me before.
You gain 500 XP for freeing Tandy. You gain 400 for returning Tandy.
She was with us the whole time? Oh my god, he's fucking dead!
Oh shit!
Damn yourself, you Brahmin freak!
Shit, he got back up. Oh, what's he doing? Oh, he's using Stimpak. Oh shit, he's flooring me! Oh fuck!
No! God!
Let's check in with Neil, right? Maybe Neil has...
Vinny is back again! With a fucking vengeance, baby!
Jesus, they're gonna take me out, dude! Oh my gosh, it's like a gang hazing!
What the fuck? I'm getting curb stomped by the fucking wizards! Shit!
There's such a weird amount of shit in there that's just like, oh, did you know, like, how many, like, cubic meters of soil had to be moved to build Vault 13? I was like, no, I didn't know. I fucking clenched my butt up a bit when I opened that. I was like, fuck, I didn't search for fucking traps, dude. Mr. Hightower, Darren Hightower,
I love you. This is more like it. Like, oh, excuse me, sir. Could I ask you a few questions? Or I'm gonna fucking kill you!
Son of a bitch, I'm a puzzle. You help me put myself together? Oh, fuck! Jesus Christ!
Hey, Kalnor. I'm already in the town. You don't gotta say that.
Oh, great. Kalnor, I've been in here. Come on, I killed Vinny 3 times. Come on, you don't gotta do that.
Yep, be a perfect opportunity to test out our brand spanking new. Oh my god, what can I say? I'm the luckiest fucking guy in the fucking wasteland.
Oh my god, it is Keith David! Fuck me! This is fucking Keith David! I fucking knew it!